Welcome back, YouTube, to another episode of Drop. I'm your host, Mike. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Visit my Mar Artist 11 page on Instagram for all the latest dates of my shows coming up. Episode number 14 is a good one. Got a chance to visit Vegas. So, let's go. So I just got back with some friends from Vegas, a much needed trip. The last day we were there in the morning, we were able to go to Urban Necessities, one of the stores that I follow on, you know, YouTube and Instagram. Jay-Z Lopez is the owner. If you don't know his story, it's a great story. He started off, he was homeless, then he bought a pair of shoes for $40 and flipped them. And that just kind of started. And then he started working for different shops. Long story short, now he owns his own business called Urban Necessities down in Las Vegas. He's in the fashion show mall. That's where we stopped by. But he's relocated into the Caesars Palace right by the Nike outlet that's right there. It's pretty cool. But it's a great location. He also just recently opened a New York location. So he's doing successful things. It was great to run into him. I can't believe he was there when we were there. We talked sneakers for a couple minutes. He was nice enough to take a picture, asked where we were from. So the whole experience was great. Check out some B-reel of my experience there at the store. I recorded it. It's a great store. So if you guys ever get a chance to go check it out, I suggest you do. Any type of shoe, hype, everything. He's got it all, clothing and everything. So let's see the reel. Let's check it out.
Damn, just all the shoes. All the fucking shoes. Dude, look, they even like, these are all dumps and shit. Dude, how do you even look at every shoe though, bro? Here's the Jordan wall. Bro, they have the metallics, look. I have the purple one. I've got the green one.
What is this one?
How much? How do you do this? Scan it or what? Oh, you gotta have a passport.
Look. Is it just a day pass?
Can you scan it?
Dave Malibu too.
What?
So there was some footage of the store, just me and my friend Jared walking around, checking out what the inventory that Urban Necessities has to offer. They've got a great pricing system. Every shoe is wrapped and has a little QR code. You scan it in your phone and it tells you how many sizes and are available in that shoe, what the prices are, if the box is damaged, if it's a brand new shoe, dead stock. So I thought that was really cool. You can go and do it on your own. You don't have to bother all the salespeople. They just ring up the shoe, go and get it in the back, and then they bring it back to show you in person. So that you know the shoe's back and it's taken care of in the back. So I thought that was a pretty cool, you know, service that they provide. If you can't tell what shoe I picked, there were so many. I went for the red Jordan 1 Off-White. They had an 11 and a half, only one pair, for $5,900. That shoe retails for $170. So I thought that was pretty crazy. It wasn't even my size, but for that pricing, the profit on that, it's just like a stock. They also had the Union Jordan 1. They had a size 10, which is my size. I can wear a size 10 or 10 and a half. They had one for $2,500, brand new. Again, $2,500 for the Union 1. I just couldn't pull the trigger on that one. They had the Trophy Room Jordan 1, the Backdoor Jordan, as everybody calls it. They had a 10 and a half, my size, for $3,326. Again, that shoe was for $170 or $190, so you can see the profit on that shoe, brand new. And they finally had a Jordan 1 Travis Scott 10 and a half, brand new, dead stock. So I went ahead and picked up this shoe. It's like a collector's item for me. One day, if I, ever get rid of it, but this one I just went after because of the hype, and the quality of the shoe, how it changed the game, the whole story. It's just one of those shoes that you have to add in your collection if you're a collector. I was super excited to get this shoe there with the experience, meeting the owner, Jay-Z Lopez, and then picking up one of the shoes that I have, comparing it to the Mocha Jordan 4, the Jordan 1 Carolina that I just got. I also have, some of the Jordan 1 Mochas to compare now. And you can see the quality difference, but you can also see a lot of the similarities. So as a collector, what a great trip. I'm glad I got a chance to go with my friends again. So guys, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe, like, let me know what you guys think about these shoes. These are amazing, great addition to the collection. Thank you for spending time with me today. Check out my Mar Artist 11 page once again. So have a great day, guys, and we'll see you next time.